This is a good win. It's a different win, but a really good win. So I think our guys deserved a lot of credit for, you know, the mental focus and the energy that they played with.
Welcome in, Hawks fans. It's your boy Bryce Wills back at it again for another Atlanta Hawks wrap-up. Hawks get another good win tonight, 134-116 over the Washington Wizards as they officially clinch being in the play-in. We just now have to know what spot it will be, and it will probably be the eighth seed, but, you know, obviously crazy things can happen. Maybe they can get to the seventh. Maybe they fall off the last two games and the Raptors win. You never know. But realistically, good win tonight, good team basketball, and they needed that. I think, you know, in this game against the Wizards tonight, Wizards didn't play their starters. They pretty much are packing it in for the year. And that's what's going to happen these last couple of games. You got teams going to play their young guys. They're going to got teams evaluating. So you're not always going to get the best people out there unless you're playing a team who's fighting for play-in position or fighting for a playoff spot or fighting for something at this point. If not, you're going to get a lot of guys who are just going to like, hey, we're just going to chill out. We're just going to play our reserves. We're going to play our young guys, see what they can do. The Hawks did that tonight, and they played the Wizards, and they were able to, and they should have won the game the way they did tonight. They started off a little slow, but bounced back. It got the rhythm going, especially in that second quarter going into the third. And, you know, they got some good performances tonight from guys. I mean, Trey came back tonight at 25 in the game. 16 assists. Big assist night for Trey Young. 16 whole assists. So he was definitely playmaking for his teammates. DeJounte with 19. And somebody made a comment on Twitter about, I feel like DeJounte is getting more comfortable. And I agree with that because I feel like the shots he's taking are better. He's either just going straight to the paint, or if the defense gives him space, he'll take the mid-range. And I've seen that a couple of times, especially in tonight's game. And I think that's good. I feel like sometimes he was forcing, like he was trying to do dribble behind the back, trying to get into a spot to hit the mid-range. And then it's a tough mid-range. And it's like, if you're going to take a mid-range, don't make it tough on yourself. If it's a good in-rhythm shot, then take it. Because, you know, playing offense, you play basketball before, you want to be in rhythm when you're taking shots. JC had a big third quarter, really exploded in the third quarter, hit a couple of threes, had a great reverse dunk. He really gave the Hawks a jolt in that third quarter, so he finished with 23 in the game. So really, really big to see JC playing really well. Like I said, over the last 10 games, he's played better. And you're seeing that, and tonight was another example of that. And Capella had 9 and 8. Then, you know, you get to the bench. Okongwu had foul trouble tonight. Really, if you think about Okongwu, one of the big issues we had earlier in the season, it felt like he was always in foul trouble. And I feel like, I feel like we haven't had to deal with that in the last few games. Like, he's been pretty good. And that's why he's been effective. He's been on the floor. He's played 20, 22, 23 minutes because he hasn't been getting into foul trouble. And this was the first time. Even he played 24 minutes, even with foul trouble. So, clearly, you know, he's done a good job, you know, doing what he's needed to do out there and playing at a high level. But tonight just wasn't a great night from 2-8 from the field with foul trouble. But, you know, he'll bounce back. But obviously, you know, I got to talk about my guys tonight. AJ Griffin and Jalen Johnson, again, playing really well. 16 apiece for both. AJ really had the shot going. 4-6 from 3 tonight. So clearly, you know, he was hitting threes, knocking down big shots that were there. Open shots on top of that as well. Just really playing well and really showing Snyder, you know, you can play me. You know, when this team gets healthy, you know, AJ sometimes is very, you know, iffy if he's going to play or not. And I feel like this stretch really should help Snyder feel more comfortable playing AJ, especially like when we get into the postseason. You know, obviously teams shorten their lineups, but Hawks, I feel like, have enough depth to go with AJ if they want to. And then Jalen Johnson continued to impress. I mean, first half, he had 11 points, finished the game with 16. I mean, he's just been growing before our eyes. He's been playing so well. And tonight was another example, bullying Wizards defenders. Another fast break dunk. It feels like we're watching, again, not saying he's LeBron, but just those highlight plays like that. Playing strong defense, had 8 rebounds tonight. Had a good assist on the alley-oop to Bay. Just really did a lot of good things tonight, man. And Snyder talked about it before the game, too, talking about he's a basketball player. He could just do so many things for the team, and I think that in itself makes him so valuable to this team and why so many people are kind of really, just really excited about the growth of Jalen. because of that. And like I'm really happy for him, really proud of the guy. Like I said, people have been all over Twitter today talking about, you know, Nate McMillan held Jalen back. Because I don't see how you would see this in practice or see this wherever you saw this and say, yeah, that can't be in my rotation. And Snyder sees that, and I think teams are seeing that. And honestly, Jalen playing this way is actually the best way to play in this moment with the Hawks going into a play-in situation and potentially further into a playoff series. Jalen may be a big X factor for the Hawks when that comes. But overall tonight, I think as a team, Bogey sat out tonight. Obviously, he doesn't really play in back-to-backs, you know, because of the knee. And he didn't really need to. I mean, Hawks shot 51%, 43% from three. 30 assists. Also, they've won the assist battle last few games, and they've won the rebound bounding for like a lot of games too, and they've done a good job from that perspective. And overall, I think this team is really getting into a rhythm, playing some good ball right now, which you need to see. They're on a three-game winning streak, which is really, really positive momentum going towards their last couple of games of the regular season. Big game, I guess, coming up against 76ers on Friday. Sixers clinched the two seed. Well, not two seed. They clinched the three seed today. Boston clinched the two seed today, but Philly clinched the three seed today. And so they don't really have much to play for. So the expectation is that the Sixers probably won't play their starters. Obviously, we'll see. They still have another game left themselves after that. So maybe Doc won't rest them to that final regular season game. But, you know, it just depends, man. Like, if you're the Hawks, I mean, you win this game, you lock up that eighth spot, and you know you're playing Miami in the play-in game. If you lose and Toronto wins, now you have to win the last game of the season against the Celtics, and Toronto has to either lose or also, again, you have to win and they win to still have the tiebreaker over them. So realistically, it feels like eight's going to be where the Hawks are going to be at. And like I said, they're going to probably go to South Beach and play the Heat for the right to battle the Boston Celtics in the first round of the playoffs. It's funny, I see a lot of people talking about the Bucks. But I mean, realistically, guys, for that to happen, if they're going to be the AFC, they have to lose to Miami to play in, which realistically you don't want to happen. I mean, because you just don't ever want your team to lose. But, you know, if you really want that to be the matchup, they would need to lose that and then beat whoever comes out of the Bulls and Raptors playing. So that's going to be interesting to kind of see, because obviously I think a lot of people look at Boston as not a really great matchup. And whoever, if the Hawks get out of the play-in game and get into the playoffs, obviously I'll have a video breaking down whoever they're playing, either if that's Boston or Milwaukee, and just talk about the matchups in that series. But overall, man, like I said, good performance tonight from the guys. They play it well. They need to do. They beat up on two bad teams. Usually the Hawks have sometimes struggled against bad teams in the past, and they were able to come out and play well tonight, and they handled business, and that's what you want to see. Guys play well, and if they continue to play with this rhythm and chemistry and just confidence going, and like I said, into the end of the regular season, maybe like Snyder said, maybe they can make a run. Maybe they can shock some people. Maybe they can turn some heads. I mean, you never really know. I mean, the Hawks did it a couple years ago. Why can't they do it again? You just don't know. So it's really encouraging to see some of the things that we've seen these last few games from this team, especially after that Brooklyn game. Kind of feels like that was a bottoming out period, especially, I mean, they had some bad losses, but, you know, that one was also a really bad loss in a big game, and they've kind of responded since that game, winning three in a row. So that's big as a team to respond from that type of adversity. But, you know, like I said, good win tonight for the guys, and, you know, we're going to have to see what happens on Friday against Philadelphia, and if Philadelphia is going to play their starters. But it's your boy, Bryce Lewis. This is your Atlanta Hawks wrap-up. I'll see you next time.